Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this afternoon, Lord, for the name which is above every name. Father, it is in his name, the name of Jesus, that we come boldly unto your throne of grace to obtain mercy and to find grace to help in the time of need. We thank you today, God, that when we seek and search for you with all of our hearts, we will find you. Thank you, God, that you're not far from any of us. There's no need for us to say, who shall ascend up into heaven, that is to bring Christ down from above? Or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring up Christ again from the dead? But what says the scripture? The word is nigh us, even in our mouths, that if we confess with our mouths the Lord Jesus and believe in our hearts that you have raised him from the dead, we will be saved. And God, we believe. We ask you to help our unbelief. We rebuke the devil in the name of Jesus. And we give you, God, the glory. And we give you the praise in Jesus' name. And for his sake, let the church say amen, and you may be seated. You can give him a praise, because from the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. You may be seated in his name. What a rich, powerful, blessed conference this is. And I don't know about you. But I've gotten several words from the Lord. I have been encouraged all over again, Pastor Moses, to take once again the cup of salvation and to call upon the name of the Lord. I have been encouraged, Pastor Clayton, that we are seated with Christ in heavenly places. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am encouraged, Pastor Bradley, that all of our righteousness in the sight of God is as filthy rags. Hallelujah. I'm encouraged, Pastor Ben, that the God we serve, he can take a little and he can do much. Oh, magnify the Lord with me this morning. Let us exalt his name together. Quickly, I'd like to direct your attention to the New Testament section in the Bible, to the epistle or first letter by the Apostle Peter. First Peter chapter 4.
Omutume Petero esule yokuna Bible ya Yoluganda gubo omuko gwempapula 1981.
Verses 7 through 19. 1 Peter chapter 4.
Petero esule yokuna
Verses 7 through 19. It reads as follows. But the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. And above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves. For charity shall cover the multitude of sins. Use hospitality one to another without grudging. As every man hath received the gift, even so minister the same one to another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God gives. That God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom be praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice in as much as you are made partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, you may be glad also with exceeding joy. If you be reproached, if you be ostracized, if you be despised for the name of Christ, happy are you, because you're different from the rest of the world. For the Spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you. Forgive me just for a moment, but I feel like an evangelist. I remember Jesus said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. We need to bring the pulpit back to the church. But let none of you suffer as a murderer or as a thief or as an evildoer or as a busybody in other men's matters. Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? As a result, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls unto him in well-doing as unto a faithful Creator. And our key verse this afternoon, just for a little while, is verse 11, Part A. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any servant of God speaks, if any evangelist teaches, if any pastor shepherds, if any prophet prophesies, let them speak as the oracles, as the mouthpiece, as the voice of God. Because it is only what we do for Christ that will last. Bring the pulpit back to the church. We're living in the last days. I think sometimes we forget that. Other times we just don't believe it. But these are the last and evil days. Just look around. People are calling good evil. They're calling evil good. People are putting darkness for light. And light for darkness. Jesus said, we would hear of wars and rumors of wars. Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in strange and diverse places. Many shall be offended and shall betray and hate one another. False prophets shall rise and deceive many. And because lawlessness, because the lack of restraint, the love of many shall wax cold. But glory to God, they that endure unto the end, Jesus said they will be saved. And as the stage has been set for the return of Jesus Christ, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all of the world for a witness unto all nations. Jesus said, and then the end will come. Reminds me of some of the things Pastor Ben was saying this morning, Pastor Bradley. May not have a mega church. May not have a $10 million budget. But we got the word of God, which is quick and powerful. And it's sharper than any two-edged sword. And as the rain and the snow comes down from heaven, and it doesn't return back there, but it waters the earth, gives seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. The Lord says, so shall my word be that goes out of my mouth, Pastor. Heaven and earth will pass away, but Jesus' word will not pass away. In the beginning was the word. The word was with God. The word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shone in darkness. They thought they could extinguish it. They thought they could put it out. They thought they could keep it silent. But the darkness, it couldn't comprehend it. Oh, glory to God. I'm so glad that the God we serve, he never changes. It is of his mercies that the sons of Jacob are not consumed. Our God is a consuming fire. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness,
hey!
To bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but he was sent to bear witness of the light. That was the true light, which lights every man that comes into the world. He was in the world. The world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came into his own. His own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. No music. Even to them. Thank you, that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. John the apostle said, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bear witness of him and cried, saying, this is he of whom I spake. He that comes after me is preferred before me, because he was before me, and of his fullness have all we receive, and grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. That's exciting for me, because I was a sinner on my way to hell, but because of the shed blood of Jesus, I can say, oh death, where is your sting? Oh grave, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin. The strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which gives us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Somebody, anybody, bring the pulpit back to the church. I gotta go. I really do. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of the Lord. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. It is the evidence of things not seen. For by it, the elders obtained a good report. Just for a few moments, the Apostle Peter, from whose letter we read this afternoon, was one of 12 of Jesus' initial disciples. Peter probably was middle class. We know he was a fisherman and a business owner. I'm so glad, Pastor Ben, I was thinking about this morning. God doesn't just choose anybody. Hallelujah. I mean, you don't have to have a lot of money. You don't need a PhD. But the Lord knows the potential. For you see your calling, brethren, how not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But God, y'all ain't paying attention to me, but God has chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise and base things of the world and things which are despised and things which are not to bring to naught or nothing things that are. What a mighty God we serve. Peter wrote the letter sometime around 60 A.D. in the first century with the help of his secretary Silas. Apparently, The letter had a universal destination, not assigned to one particular congregation or district. The correspondence was addressed to the strangers and to the foreigners and to the exiles that had been dispersed throughout
Pontus, Galatia,
Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia. Practically all of Asia Minor or modern-day Turkey. At the time that Peter wrote this letter, the Roman Empire held the grips and the straps of the political domination over the entire known world, and persecution was on the rise against the Christians. But I'm so glad, pastors, that the Bible tells us in Romans 8 and verse 31 that if God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay charge to God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that condemns? Christ that died.
Hey!
Yea, rather, that has risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, distress, persecution, famine, nakedness, peril, sword, as it is written, for his sake we are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, no. In all these things, we're more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I'm